Fire launch their power cells. They do 1-2 right before time expires in the autonomous mode. Team Runbrants here, fifth ranked team during the qualification matches, going up against Absolute Value, which is the third ranked team. Runbrants getting up close and personal with their power port before being defended against by Eagle Strike. It's good to see that their robots on the field and moving around quite swiftly. But here come Team Runbrants up into the power port. Project 691's robot, that light is not blinking. Oh, it is blinking now. Looks like they got to get connectivity back. Absolute Value lining up for a shot on the upper power port. They get one. Oh, they missed the second one. And there's the third. La Kenyatta Engineering Club gathering those power cells into their robot from the field. Team Runbrants getting more of their own. Meanwhile, Riviera Robotics being defended against by Eagle Strike. Eagle Strike slamming Runbrants into the side of the field. There's 1, 2, 3 power cells into the upper power port for the Blue Alliance. And Riviera Robotics using their Flail of Doom. And here we go, time to hang on that switch. Let's activate those shield generators. Both Runbrants and La Kenyatta Engineering Club balancing on the switch. La Kenyatta having that mechanism, giving them the ability to automatic self-balance. But here come Absolute Value, helping the Red Alliance balance their switch as well. A preliminary score of 66-64. This is going to come down to the end game points as we eagerly await for the scores. With two robots hanging, the Red Alliance comes away with one ranking point. The Blue Alliance has three.